the forces when he was young, and he fell right into their hands. The story was spun, a steady wage in adventures, fighting terror in foreign lands. This life of a soldier had thrilled and enticed him as no other job had done. He'd read and was told of the beauty of freedom that spread by our planes and our guns. So after 2 years of service in Colchester barracks, transporting bullets and shells, through the ranks ran a murmur as the orders were given. Excitement rose and it fell. But as they descended to Kandahar city, a grim silence fell over the plain. Shots of mortars rang in the distance like threats from a sky turning grey. Joe Glenton, he has been sentenced for refusing to fight and to kill. The sharp eyes of the judge and the cold cuffs were on him as he was led away to the jail. There the days and the weeks stumbled into each other, soon the months were passing him by. Nothing was leaving the compound but coffins, and rockets tore through the night sky. Reports came daily of villages bombed to frighten insurgents away. Reports came daily of villages bombed, only bones and ashes remain. While these embers were smouldering, the story unfolded, led him to question the cause. All we have ever brought to this land are the scars and tissues of war. And as their tour drew to a close, he vowed he would never return. He told his captain, who threatened and screamed, "These thoughts are not a soldier's concern." Joe Glenton, he has been sentenced for refusing to fight and to kill. The sharp eyes of the judge and the cold cuffs were on him as he was led away to the jail. Returning home, he was faced with a choice to resist or return to the front. But the villagers' cries and the general's lies, he'd made up his mind to confront. And on the day he walked out to the barracks, to the squad he shouts for support. In the face of treason, he laid down his reasons and threw off the terrors of war. Soon the military tried to throw him in jail, and they banned him from speaking his mind. But Joe Glenton continued to follow his conscience through the hard days, the grit and the grind. Armed with only his story and all he had witnessed, he travelled and gave his account. Under threat of arrest, as he rose to address the crowd soon gathered around. Joe Glenton, he has been sentenced for refusing to fight and to kill. The sharp eyes of the judge and the cold cuffs were on him as he was led away to the jail. After months of dispute and hounding pursuit, they caught him and brought him to trial. The judge rose to address the military court and sentenced Joe Glenton to jail. No medals or crosses of gold or of bronze are pinned to Joe Glenton's lapel. No handshakes or service for courage or conscience, instead condemned to rebel. So he served his time to the prison clock's chime of 9 months that were buried and gone. Back out on the street, unrepentant, unbroken, determined to take the fight on. Well, he wasn't the first and he won't be the last to stand up and utter these tones. But the words of a rebel shake and unnerve them as other young soldiers look on. Joe Glenton, he has been sentenced for refusing to fight and to kill. The sharp eyes of the judge and the cold cuffs were on as he was led away to the jail. Joe Glenton, he was sentenced, but the criminals dance free today. There were many before him, there'll be many after, who question instead of obey.